I'm Felicity Harley McGowan. I'm a lecturer in art history here at Yale Divinity School. And I'm able to talk a little about this painting that has been hanging in the Divinity School for many decades. We are not sure at what date it entered the collection of the Divinity School and how it entered, whether someone gave the painting to the school. But as part of a process of restoring various works of art, including portraits that the school owned, this painting was sent to Kathy Hebb, a conservator, for treatment. Kathy identified it as a work that would benefit from her immense skills. And when she took it to her workshop and investigated the surface of the painting for conservation, because much of the surface of the painting was cracked with paint peeling off, she discovered underneath paint that was cracking at the bottom of the canvas, different colours beneath what was a fairly dull, overpainted, darker colour. And those colours belonged to these four figures at the bottom of the painting that had at some point in the painting's history been painted over, and Kathy, through analysing the paint, has been able to determine a rough idea of when that occurred. And the four figures that we have represent different aspects of Catholicism. They're caricatures of Catholicism. A cardinal, a pope, a monk, and here a bull as a pun on the papal bull, an official decree of the pope. So the four figures here are represented originally blowing out, or attempting to blow out, this candle that is at the center of the table. We have a central figure here, Martin Luther, a key man in the history of the Reformation in Europe. Luther seated with a Bible and a candle. Usually such paintings have a reference to the fact that the candle is lighted, we cannot blow it out. A key phrase connected to the Reformation and to a reformer in England, Hugh Latimer, who mentioned these words prior to his execution, this idea that the ideals of the Reformation will not be defeated despite the attempts of the Catholic Church. And so Luther here is seated a little like an arrangement of a Last Supper, seated at the center of the table, with the key reformers in the Reformation seated around him. And in other versions of the painting and the original prints on which they are based, the reformers are usually named. So they have specific identities in their facial characteristics, as well as usually titles to tell us who they are. So the painting really for around 150 years was an extremely popular image, setting out the key ideas of the Reformation, of Luther as this central figure, and the kind of family tree of all of the central characters in the Reformation movement, in a kind of Last Supper image, but in fact attesting to one of the key elements of the Reformation, which was that the Word of God represented in the Bible here is the key aspect of the faith, not the Eucharist, which most Catholics would see attested in representations of the Last Supper. So it's a key text rather than an image about what the Reformation is about, rather cruel caricature of Catholicism at the